Let's go to one of the Windsors where Dr. Jay Sutay is standing by. He is the hardest working pediatrician in comedy. If you live in Chicopee, you can see him May 16th, opening for Gilbert Gottfried. I may go watch that show in Chicopee. Is that Chicopee, Connecticut?
Chicopee, Massachusetts, at the new, brand new Loft Comedy Club.
Ah, wasn't Nell, the Jodie Foster movie, wasn't she from Chicopee? Wasn't
Chicopee or Holyoke?
Oh, okay.
But they're more, it's mostly the same, that little pocket there.
How old is your dog?
He is 2.5 now, and full of life, and all he wants to do is play. And if I ignore him, he gets a little, a little loud, yippy.
And you go off to work and save lives.
Yep.
What's his name?
It's Rodney.
Well, that's right.
Rodney El Duque Sute.
You go off to work. Does he bark by himself?
No, because I have the motion detector on my Amazon cloud cam. And when he moves or does something, it films a little clip. And all he ever does is sleep for an hour on the couch, get up, get a drink of water, go back, jump on the couch, sleep for another hour. So he's got he's got a pretty nice day.
So how many hours a day does Rodney sleep?
Most of them, but I go to work at, I go in for, I leave at 8, I come back around 12:30, 12:45, stay for an hour, and then I go back until 5:30, and he's fine 4 or 5 hours by himself. He just has the run of the place.
And does
I think I'm paying rent for a giant doghouse, because all I do is sleep here. He's here 24 hours a day running the joint.
Does he sleep all night?
Oh, yeah. He's just started sleeping up in bed with me, which I like. It was my last dog, Stanley. He cuddled in bed with me. And this one, this one likes to sleep on his couch. So sometimes he'll be in bed with me. He'll get off the bed and he'll bark at me to walk him downstairs to his couch, even though he's perfectly capable of walking downstairs by his own goddamn self.
How healthy?
He'll stand at that top of the stairs barking until I get out of bed and walk him downstairs. He jumps on the couch. I go back up and we're fine till the morning.
How healthy is it to have a dog? Joe DeVito's on the show today. And we were talking about dogs who lick children's faces. And he was saying, how healthy could that be? But I said, dogs give us antibodies, right?
Well, they give you exposure to more germs, so it keeps your immune system kicked up. But yeah, I think they've done studies about that, where they've looked at families that have had a pet versus families that don't have a pet, and who seems to respond quicker to infections and stuff. I could probably dig that up for the next show, but yeah, they've looked at that too.
But you can't catch a cold or anything from a dog.
No. It's different viruses affecting different species. Although, if he just lipped his balls or his ass and he gives you a wet one across the face, you don't need that.
Because you can get worms?
No, because you have shit spread across your face. You know what? Your dog giving you a dirty Sanchez.
And for adults, how healthy is it to have a dog versus a cat?
Well, I think cats are assholes, though. I'm not much of a cat person because I don't get them. But if you're an adult who's shallow and needs constant love like me, then the dog is the better choice.
And it's good for
you. He loves you no matter what. He's greeting you at the dog, wagging his tail. And the good thing is they don't know how to tell time. So he doesn't know how many drinks of water in time aliquots I'm away from him. So it's just like I just walked out. In fact, sometimes I walk out, he comes up to me like I'd been away for hours. They just don't have watches.
Okay. Now, for our young men who are about to get married and have a pregnant wife, pregnant women cannot change a cat box.
No, because of the toxoplasmosis.
And I want to ask you about toxoplasmosis in a second.
I think we've covered that, though.
I don't think we have.
Become redundant. No?
Don't worry. Okay. Don't worry.
All right.
But is there any reason my pregnant wife can't bend down and pick up dog crap?
No, that's okay.
All right. You hear that, guys?
Yeah. Again, you don't want her to get sick because it could affect the baby just because mom's sick. But, you know, the toxoplasmosis is a parasite that could actually cause the baby to be small for gestational age, could cause brain damage. It's pretty serious stuff.
Okay. And you would lose your medical license if we were to spread a rumor that men's fertility is affected by bending over to pick up dog crap. If a man is with a woman and they're trying to get pregnant, and we want the woman to pick up after the dog and not the guy, if we're trying to help
right,
her.
I get you.
We're trying to help our own here.
Right.
Would you lose your license if you helped me spread this rumor that it's bad for a man's sperm count if he bends over to pick up dog crap?
Well, the guy who spread all the nonsense about measles and autism lost his license, so I'd imagine a similar fate would befall this person.
Yeah. Okay. Cause...
Hey, you know what I thought? Speaking of dog shit, I want to develop a drone that will pick up dog shit. Okay? So you can sit on your back porch. You don't have to worry about stepping in it, and you can, with your remote control right on your iPad, dispose of your dog shit using drones.
That's a great idea.
Tell me that's not a great idea. If anybody comes up with that, it was mine.
Yeah.
Or the other idea I had.
Well, hang on for 1 second.
Poop that glows in the dark. Something you add to their food so their shit glows in the dark. So you don't have to worry about stepping on it. You can see it at night because it lights up.
Hmm.
I don't know. I'm always thinking that. Because you brought up the dog shit, but I deal with a lot of dog shit.
Well, it's a lot of valuable fruit and vegetables is being thrown out of Chernobyl. Feed your dog food from maybe. Chernobyl. It will glow
maybe,
in the dark.
Maybe if you give them hard water.
Hard water, yes.
Yeah. All right.
Niels Bohr, did he come up with hard water?
Oh, I thought it was a song.
Oh, isn't hard water something
it's a different kind of water that is, I don't know if some kind of radiation or some kind of, that's why I was making the joke that there's something about it that, I can't remember.
I think the Nazis were trying to get hard water, and Mo Berg, the Jewish baseball player, turned spy. During World War II, I believe.
Why hasn't Kevin Costner made that movie?
If you build it, you will own it.
And then you can charge admission.
I saw a documentary about Hank Greenberg, the great Jewish baseball player.
Yes, sir.
And at the end of the documentary, I think he ended up owning like the Florida Marlins or something. He ended up owning a baseball team. Look up Mo Berg. I think he had something to do with hard water and getting the recipe for hard water, which helps us make nuclear bombs. Well, you want to hear my get rich quick scheme?
I'd love to.
Okay. You know how dogs like to eat poop?
Yes.
Okay. If there's a baker out there who wants to go in business with me, I'm looking for somebody to bake dog biscuits in the shape of cat poop and dog poop.
Oh, interesting.
Isn't that a great idea?
I think it is a great idea.
And I would sell it.
I didn't know where you were going. I thought you were going somewhere else, but this idea I like.
And what I think, here's the thing, and if there's a baker out there who wants to go into business with me, because I've always wanted to get rich and just drop ship shit. I think that if you fed your dog a biscuit that looked like dog shit or cat shit, that dog would stop eating regular dog shit and cat shit because he would say, well, this is bad shit. The real shit tastes bad. I'm gonna
eat the other stuff. I don't think they look at shapes and stuff. I think most of it's smell. And honestly, even though we give our dogs biscuits in the shape of a dog bone, they don't know what the fuck a dog bone is.
Yeah.
That you could give it it could be a circle, a square, a triangle. They don't care.
Hey, let me ask you this.
Yes, sir.
Is it healthy for a dog to eat shit?
Probably not. If it's theirs, maybe. But my dog, the Stanley, used to go in the woods and feast upon deer droppings.
Hmm.
So
and they're parasites and things.
But you know what? Dog lived till he was 13. Have a hardy constitution. Got to eat a lot of deer droppings to live a good, long, healthy life.
What if we sold healthy dog shit for your dog? In other words,
healthy shit to eat?
Healthy shit for your dog to eat.
Man, I think there's dog food out there, and I mean, are we in a third world country here? Maybe we could recycle dog shit into dog food somewhere else, but I don't see that flying in this country.
Okay, just trying to make a buck here off my listeners.
We just have to change the name to Al Poo.
Yes, I don't know why dogs love crap,
and they love to roll in it, and they love to roll in dead birds, and who the hell knows.
I was told that cat shit for a dog is a delicacy. Now I've eaten cat shit, and you know, it tastes okay, but I wouldn't call it a delicacy.
I haven't been close enough to a cat. I got to know them well enough to even think about eating their shit. But I will let my dog eat lick my eye sockets because I find it very relaxing.
Tell me about toxoplasmosis. Women go crazy from it, right?
Right. Yeah, it's a parasite that cats can have. And if they pass it on to pregnant ladies, it can have the ill effects of stuff. But, you know, much like your, the Zika, which we've talked about before. But, it's a parasite.
It's a parasite, so women can actually change because of this.
Oh,
the body snatchers.
The body snatchers. That's right. That's what I was trying to come up with that.
But a woman's personality can be,
if she's got toxoplasmosis, Gandhi in there, makes them more Gandhi-like.
I heard a little more. No, not Gandhi. The guy who shot Gandhi, it makes her more like that.
Yeah, but they can have miscarriages because of it. Babies can have brain problems. They can be blind. There's lots of stuff that could cause trouble with babies. So the eyes being a big deal.
Cats belong outside. I know we have PETA on the show once
a week.
They're
serial killers.
They
cats
are
serial killers. They like to stalk and kill. And then show their proud accomplishments, and they scare the hell out of me.
They belong outside. I know this is sacrilege. I'm going to get more letters, but
they like being outside, though. That's what they do.
And they should be declawed, so it's a fair fight. So they don't murder all these birds because they kill birds. So
yeah.
Declaw them, make it a fair fight, and let nature take its course. I mean, I mean that, and I'm a vegan, and I love cats, but they belong outside.
Yeah, outside in New York isn't all that easy, though. You know how hard it would be to drive in New York if everyone left their cats outside? Imagine that?
I don't think in New York it would be hard at all.
Well, traffic's at a standstill all the time, so it's not going to move anyhow. There'd be an increase in roadkill, though.
Yeah, I don't think a New Yorker stops for a cat. Hey, speaking of eating shit, Big Macs.
Yeah, I wanted to tell you about this. It's funny. Some guy floated a Big Mac into space, and then when it came back to Earth, ate it. So I want to tell you, what you thought about this. An English man launched a Big Mac hamburger 24 miles into the stratosphere using a weather balloon and then ate the space burger upon its return to the ground. Thomas Stanilin said he accomplished the feat with the aid of 4 canisters of helium, a GoPro camera, a GPS tracker, a polystyrene box, and super glue. That seemed pretty simple to accomplish this, by the way. After the balloon popped and the burger floated back to Earth, he recovered it. It'd been outside for a while, so it was a bit crumbly, he said, but described the taste as not so nice. So I just thought that was a fascinating story, that someone would take the time to put these devices together simply to float a Big Mac up into the stratosphere to see what it would taste like afterwards. Like I said many times, not enough Indians.
Well, if it went into space, wouldn't it be frozen?
Well, when it comes back down, it could. But what if a plane is flying? What if this Big Mac distracts some pilot? I don't know. It just seemed like a dangerous thing.
Maybe he accidentally ate blue ice and thought.
No, he had a tracker. It was inside something, and it had GPS tracker so he could find it when he came back down to Earth. A lot of effort went into this.
Yeah. Amazing. And some woman gave birth to the weirdest triplets, you say.
Yeah, triplets the hard way. She gave birth to twins, and then 26 days later gave birth to another baby. And she had no idea, nor did her OBGYN, know that she had two uteruses.
You can have two uteruses?
Apparently it's a one of every million women can have what's known as a uterus didelphus. And that is two uteruses. She was carrying twins in one, and in one that I guess was hidden somewhere else in her body. She had another baby a month later. So three babies, could, you know, triplets, but not born on the same day. Kind of
same kinda father.
Well, that we don't know from
same egg.
Well, probably wasn't the same egg because they delivered at different times. It could have been the twins may have been. They don't say in the article whether it's fraternal or paternal twins or whether they were even conjoined for that matter. But they didn't say if they were identical twins in the two that came out of the one uterus. But the other one would have been a separate fertilization altogether.
Mm. So twins come from the same egg?
They can or they don't. It can be one egg that splits and they develop into identical twins, or it can be two eggs that, for whatever reason, that's what mom produced that month, and they get fertilized by two different sperm, and then you can have you can have a boy twin and a girl twin, and their genetics are different. So
one sperm can only fertilize one egg.
Right. Once it cracks the code, gets in the shell, and the shell makes a almost like a proof, some kind of barrier that doesn't allow any more to get in. It's fascinating.
Now, does the sperm die, or what happens?
No, it becomes the genetic material from the sperm combines with the genetic material from the egg, and they have a little chromosomal hoedown, and things come together, and they create a whole new genetic person.
Hmm. Interesting.
And then if that itself splits, that's how you could have identical twins, if it splits and separates. And the other way, two eggs get produced by mom that month, and, you know, the sperm are very aggressive. They'll check every nook and cranny for an egg.
Hmm. Now, what happens if you put sperm on a table?
What, for dinner?
I mean, does it start looking for eggs?
No, I don't think so. It doesn't look for eggs when I shoot it in a tissue.
He's
right there.
I hear Rodney. Right, Rodney's drinking.
Yeah, he's having a little water right behind me.
Little Rodney. Listen,
he ain't that little. You look at him from above, he's got a little head and a long tail. He looks like a fucking armadillo.
So sperm doesn't move. Like, if you were to leave sperm on, say, a computer keyboard.
Desktop, a keyboard. Yeah.
Is it possible?
It's not going anywhere.
It doesn't move.
Well, it's moving for a little while, but it doesn't live outside of people very, very long.
Like, how long does sperm live?
I don't know. I don't know. Should I Google lifespan of a sperm?
Can't you just make something up?
I would imagine it's, unless it's inside something nice and warm, it doesn't last very long because, you know, you can, you know,
suppose
shoot
it's
it
the summer.
Someone's back and then they take a shower and it dribbles down into that area and it's not going anywhere. It's not.
A hot day. How long will it?
Okay. Listen, I'm not a weatherman, David.
I mean, if you leave sperm on a seat on a hot day and somebody goes and sits down and she's a woman and she's, you know,
moist.
Yeah. Could she get
and
pregnant?
There's a suction effect when she gets up.
What about if
you? I'm talking about.
What if you masturbate in your bathtub?
Oh, we've talked about this. I know. I'm sure we've talked about this, about how long it lives in the water, the hot water.
We talked about this. We talked about this.
We have, because I was staying. I was staying. It pops into my head often.
So. I was staying at your house. We had finished up a gig.
That's right.
And you said, stop masturbating in my tub.
And I had to bring the Clorox out to kill everything.
But there's no way you can impregnate a member of your family if you masturbate in the tub, right?
I don't know. How are you in the tub with your relative? I mean, there's a lot of variables. I can't really make that call.
Okay. And finally, I read about tumors with teeth, and they've opened them up, and it's the beginnings of a baby. Is that possible?
Well, it could be parts of the body. There have been dermoid cysts that have been removed that have had teeth and body parts and other thing in them. It's something that you're usually born with, and I'm not sure exactly what the origin is. Sometimes people have them, you can have them anywhere on your body, but most of the time in pediatrics, we don't find the ones that are like intra-abdominal. They tend to have them above their eyebrows.
And, I see.
But again, nothing really cool has been found in any of the ones I've known about. I mean, it'd be nice to get like somebody's growing a big toe in their head or something. But yeah. No, we've got none of that shit going on up here.
And vagina dentata is just a figment of your imagination.
Is that like Hakuna Matata?
Yes. What a lovely word. Vagina dentata. It's dentata. It's this fear, I believe, Southwestern Indians.
Oh, of teeth?
In the vagina. Now, that's not, that's never been.
Not unless somebody lost their bridge work.
Dr. Jay Sutay is the hardest working pediatrician in comedy. If you live in Chicopee, that's Massachusetts. You can see him May 16th, opening for Gilbert Gottfried. What a great show. Can you stand on the line for 1 second, sir?
You betcha. Good to talk to you, David.
Good to talk to you.